Hello everyone, and welcome back to our character creator series in Godot 4. Before we jump into the main steps of creating our system, we first need to establish our base of our project. In case you're wondering, I'm using Godot version 4.2.1 as of the release of this video. So let's go ahead and open up our Godot editor and let's create a new project. I'm going to call my project Character Creator, and I'm also going to save it in a folder where I can easily find it. You can create your project in either Forward Plus or Compatibility mode, it doesn't really matter. Whilst our project is being created, let's head over to the GitHub repository that I created for this project. You can find the link to this repository in the description box below, as well as in the pinned comment. Now, this repository contains all of the assets that we will need for this project, as well as the sectional code, which is the project code that you can reference after each video. You can also find the credits to the assets, which I found on itch.io down below if you'd like to check out the creator of the content that we will use in our project. Now, download the folder called Assets. As the name suggests, this folder contains all of the assets which we will use for our project. After the folder has finished downloading, unzip it and drag the folder into your newly created project. Then, let's create two new folders, one to hold our scenes and one to hold our scripts. You can also go ahead and delete the icon.svg file. We'll have to create a main scene in which our player will spawn on. You'll usually also have your main scene spawn your world and other components, but since we'll only be focusing on the character creator, our main scene will only spawn our player. So let's create a new scene and add a node2d node as the root node. Rename this node to main. And then we'll save this scene in our scenes folder. We'll leave this scene for now since we don't have our player scene to spawn yet. Now, with our assets imported and our main scene created, we'll need to do one last thing, and that is to change a few settings in our project settings. So open up your project settings window and navigate to rendering texturing. We need to change the texture filter of our sprites to make sure that our sprites are not blurry or foggy. If we leave the filtering on linear, everything will look a bit blurry. Now to fix this, we'll need to change our filtering to nearest. Nearest neighbor filtering is often preferred when working with pixel art to keep the crisp edges in our art. Linear filtering is preferred when you want a smoother, more realistic image, such as in 3D environments. Okay, so let's change our texture filtering from linear to nearest. Now, our future 2D pixels, which we will add later on, should be sharp and crystal clear and not blurry and foggy because it's trying to render 3D objects. When we create our player, we'll add a camera to our player and add a zoom value to that camera. So because of this, we'll also need to change our stretch mode of our sprites so that our graphics are scaled to fit the screen size. So each time we zoom in, our graphics will be scaled proportionately. Navigate to Display Window and change the stretch mode to Canvas Items. Like I said, this will scale the graphics at a constant rate, which will prevent our images from being distorted and our sprites from looking non-linear. And that is it for now. In the next part, we will set up our player scene and we will give our player some movement without animations. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.